right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Evan Gappelberg, the CEO of NexTech AR Solutions. And Evan, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm good. Great to be back, Steve.
Yeah, so you put out some preliminary third quarter financial numbers, and the numbers, again, are showing a big increase in specifically 3D modeling. And let's start there. Obviously, you're pretty happy with what you're seeing, up almost 170%.
I am. And, you know, the 3D modeling business showing 170% sequential growth, that means quarter over quarter, is quite dramatic. It really does set the stage for a fantastic Q4 and 2023. We also announced today, Steve, a $700,000 3D model contract, which will be delivered in Q4. So if you look at the scale, if you look at the size of the contracts, everything we've been talking about on your show for the past 6 months is now coming to fruition.
Let's talk about revenue as well, because you, in there, you talk about, you know, total revenue for the quarter, about $3 million and gross profit, about $1.25 million. So are you happy where that's at? And do you see that obviously continuing?
I actually see things improving. And it's important to note, Steve, we broke down our revenue. We have legacy business, and then we have our going forward 3D modeling and technology services business. If you look at our Q3 numbers for our going forward business, revenue was up 66% sequentially, hitting about $920,000 for the quarter. And again, 3D modeling revenue specifically up 170%. 3D model production, which means the number of 3D models that we produced in Q3 over Q2, was up 110%. Our gross margin is improving quite dramatically, up 48%, hitting a 55% gross margin in Q3. But the story is that all these numbers are trending up at a very, very rapid rate. It's important to focus on these numbers and not our legacy e-com business. So yeah, we're going to report roughly $3 million in revenue. Of that, roughly $2 million was the legacy e-com business, but that isn't the story. The story is not the top line. The story is really focusing on the 3D model and technology services revenue, because that is what is scaling. That is what is going to continue to grow at a rapid clip in Q4 and 2023 and beyond.
Now, you mentioned Q4, and you did mention the $700,000 3D model contract that you have. Are there more of those type of things in the pipeline moving forward? Because you have talked about, you know, the revenue sort of spread out over quarters.
There are. So that's a chunky one for, yeah, for Q4. But there are some quite substantial multi-million-dollar orders that we are working on RFPs for. And they could close in Q4 2022. These orders are multi-year supply contracts. These are not insignificant. These represent multi-year contracts, because nobody can deliver the quantity of 3D models that's required in a single year. This really is a decade-long mega trend, in my view. And we are just at the beginning. We turn the corner really into Q2. We're now accelerating in Q3. We're going to continue to see an acceleration in Q4 and into 2023 and beyond. I just also want to mention that yesterday, October 12th, we had our AGM, the annual general meeting for shareholders to approve the spin out of ARway and other events. That has happened. We received shareholder approval yesterday, which means that the spin out of ARway is moving forward and should happen before the end of this month, likely the last week of the month.
All right, we'll leave it there. Evan, thanks so much for the update. Appreciate it. Good to talk to you again.
Thanks, Steve.
Evan Gappelberg, the CEO of NexTech AR Solutions.